Hello everyone, Pedro here with GetResponse, and in this video I want to show you how to add a signup form to your website. A signup form is a key element in any website as it will help you grow your list, and also you can gather more information about your subscribers, as for example their country, their mobile phone, their profession, and this will be very useful when you segment your emails. Let's go and get started. To add the signup form, you go to the right to add elements here, and then form. You click and drag at the same time to where you want to drop the form for it to be placed. Let's drop it here, right below ours. And then do not confuse the contact form to signup form. The contact form will not add people to your list. Let's click on it. And as you can see, it's already placed. As I already have one, I will be deleting this one. To delete, you just click here. And now let's go through the settings quickly. The first one is name. Now this name is just for you. Just pick a name that allows you to identify the form. Next you have the fields. You can change the position of the fields here. As you can see, if you click and drag, let's change here just for you to see they already changed. And let's add another field. I want the mobile phone. And to edit, you just click here, edit. You can either edit the label. I want mobile to be written, and I want to make it required. So people can only subscribe if they fill this field. Let's click save, and then let's go to consent fields. A consent field is a field that allows you to store and track the consent from your customers, so their permission for you to send messages. In my case, I have already created a consent field. Make sure that you check our FAQ on that. And it's about, I want to receive marketing emails from Pedro. You can create something similar for you, for your business. Following that, we have the success view. The success view is, in other words, what people will see when they click to subscribe. I have two examples prepared for you. And the first one regarding showing a message. So people will remain the same page when they click to subscribe. And they will see, thank you for subscribing. Here's the example. Thank you for subscribing. Here it is. And the next one is to redirect them to another page. Can be from the current website. Usually that's a thank you page, or you can redirect them to an external page that you would like to share with them, or a landing page that you have. Can be your sales page, for example. If you have a sales funnel, custom protocol, this will execute a protocol for you. A website, it's any website that you have inside GetResponse will appear here. You'll be able to select, and also the page from that website, it will appear here as well. In my case, I will be redirecting them to a special page that I have, that it is hidden, and only subscribers will see it. They will be redirected to this page, and this page has a discount for them. And here's an example. As you can see, they can then see that page, and it's something nice to offer in exchange for their email address. Following that, you have the subscription settings. Here is where you select the list that people will join when they subscribe, and then you can either send an opt-in confirmation email or not. If you have it enabled, a confirmation email will be sent before they are added to the list. In this email, there is a URL, and the subscribers, they need to click on it to be added to your list. If they don't, they will remain in the unconfirmed list. If you want them to be added instantly, just disable this option. The next option is to add people to the autoresponder cycle. If you have an autoresponder already configured, make sure to select the correct day here. And then you have the design and block settings. They are very intuitive. I will not go through all of them. I will go through the first one, through the label. As you can see, everything will be for you to select. You can edit the font size, write your text here, for example, can be required. And you can see how it is displayed, or if we want asterisk. Let's go back, and the other settings will be very intuitive. You'll go through them through fill and button. Then block settings. We can change the color of the background here. It's the most important thing for you to get started. And then you can adjust the padding, border, radius, shadow. I will let you go through it. Lastly, we have absolute positioning. This one is interesting. If you click on it, what you can do is to drag your form anywhere in the website. Its position is absolute, right? So you can drag anywhere. The only issue with this is that you might need to check how your website is displayed on mobile devices, as it will be harder for it to be responsive when you have absolute positioning enabled. So make sure to check before you publish your website. I will keep it disabled. And then you can hide from mobile devices. This means that if someone accesses your page from a mobile phone or mobile device, they will not see the form in this case. I hope you enjoyed this video. That's everything. And I challenge you now to add a signup form to your page. Stay tuned for more videos and have a great day.